it will be virtually repetition of so many things. What we are trying really, that we are even trying, that I have spoken, that even if you are ECC surgeon, you can do it very good. And try to learn all the techniques of phaco and ascites through the ECC, and that is rexis and hydrodissection. Once you do that, rotate the nucleus, make it free, then your phaco and ascites becomes easy. I'm going to Blumenthal's. I don't know, people are scared of putting this anti-chamber maintainer. It's a wonderful thing. You put a just side port, insert it, and your chamber is full. You are saving the cornea all the time. So Blumenthal's and this anti-chamber maintainer for your vitrectomy, for your hard nucleus, for your intumescent nucleus, for everyone. So this is Blumenthal, means a frown incision. And Blumenthal basically was using straight incision and radial cut. What we are doing is frown incision and radial cut. This is proven that frown incision induces less astigmatism than a straight incision. That funnel which Dr. Ruchi has talked, that incision will remain within that funnel if you make a frown or if you make a virtually U-shaped incision. Nucleus will come. Professor Khurana, welcome. We were just missing you. Professor Khurana is one. Your books you read, his books you read all. So, rexis, big rexis, and you know the zonules are inserted from sides up to 2.5 millimeter. In fact, you have got only 5 millimeter of the nucleus, which is free of the zonules. So you will enter into zonules, but if you go more periphery, that more zonules, and then it will be difficult to handle it, of course. Anti-chamber maintainer insertion is so easy. Make a cut, just go on and keep on rotating it like a screw. It will stay there. And anterior chamber maintainer, I told you, never collapses the chamber. And pressurized chamber is one you want in SIC and FACO. That chamber should never collapse by any method. All other methods, chamber might collapse. But we want chamber all the time full so that you don't get CME. You don't get the exudation in the choroid, you don't get exudation in the retina. And of course, the taking nucleus out of the bag, that larger the chamber, the rexis is easy. You can do the can opener cut on the sides, little hook-shaped, coma-shaped cut, so that your bag remain intact. Once the nucleus in the chamber, this is our technique that we have modified the Blumenthal. I inject visco through the anti-chamber maintainer, and not the fluid, what Blumenthal originally did. So you can see the bubble and the visco. This produces so much high pressure on the wound and not leaking like fluid, that nucleus has to go to the section. So kitna bhi, the largest nucleus will enter this wound, and with a 23 gauge needle straight, you can rotate it out. You can cartwheel it out like this. You can bring it out like this. So, and chamber is full of the visco, which is dispersive, which is cheap, which is methyl cellulose, and you can see it is sticking on the back of the cornea, and these bubbles would not go till the end. And that we have done the calculation that the endothelial cell count are much better with this kind of technique than any phaco in hard cataract. So special, and this is the cheapest irrigation aspiration. You can use in phaco if your irrigation aspiration is not working, that you put anti-chamber maintainer, another cannula from side port, and you go anywhere, chamber is full, and you can take out the cortex, the episcleral, the epinucleus, anything at all. And then you can inject the lens, a foldable lens, and give the benefit of the foldable lens. And biggest benefit of the foldable lens is that less PCO. And you tell patient, of course, he feels happy that you have given him foldable. And since your incision was very small, very good, away from cornea, so nothing will remain. Hydrate the incisions wherever you made them, and cauterize this one, and it is as good as phaco in every sense. This is SICS with is a small pupil, and you can pull the iris. You don't have to use the iris hooks. Pull the iris with your Sinsky and take the turn to bring the rexis. So sometimes these don't dilate at all. You may have the iris hooks, apply them, but they make the chamber shallow, and it becomes difficult sometimes. But once you have used the hooks, do the RXs and remove them. Otherwise, chamber will remain shallow with them. In FECO also, once you have done the RXs, you can remove them, and you should remove them. So I'm using blue menthol, and I recommend blue menthol. I don't know people are scared of, why they are scared of that. And this was within the wound itself, I made a flap for RXs. So RXs was done there, and then lens was injected, lens was placed. I want to reduce the time. How can I reduce?
Let it be. You can't do it. Ho jayega. I'm switching. Let them see how it is done. Travis to run.
So these are two small cuts, vertical. You can make with a lens, the small lancet, or you can make even with the needle. And once you make them, this cut can be, so you don't have to use any punch, neither big punch nor small punch. And then you suture the flap for trabe. And since incision was frown, and frown ke the upper we made the flap for the trabe, so this will remain sutureless. And this, of course, we will make a bleb forming suture that is going from conjunctiva to the cornea. Then, so this is a bleb forming suture, that is, you put kind of a mattress through the conjunctiva, through the cornea, and you can see the bleb form right on the table. Once you put this one, the bleb is formed right at the table. I think this is the end. Thank you very much.
Any questions, or should we?